Rabbit, rabbit, welcome to NBA Today, joined by Tanae Agumake, Ramona Shelburne, and Kendrick Perkins is going to be beaming in momentarily.
Beaming in.
And everyone have a good weekend?
Oh, great weekend.
Great weekend. You got your
trick or treat. Halloweening.
Yeah.
With Daniel. Little ones. Yeah.
What was Danny?
He was a little piggy.
Oh, my gosh. Pig. Love it. I love it. All right. Diving into the NBA today, Ramona, you have an update on Joel Embiid. What can you tell us?
Well, he's going
free
to
throws.
Sit.
And let's go to the board. Why don't you guys come with me so I can break it all down.
Break it down.
What I really love about James Harden is that he walks the walk and he doesn't talk the talk. He'll let his game speak volumes. So give me a take.
Some of the top from this weekend's action. And first up is top handles. Let's go to Svee going behind the back. We'll start there.
Oh, smooth.
Oh.
Yeah, that's like the cone drill. You know when you play basketball as a kid and you go here, bam, right there. That's clean.
He was like, all right, this is my human cone, and I'm just going to move right through it.
When you dunk, you get extra
points. Move right through it. And then we're going to also head to Chicago. DeMar DeRozan.
Oh, I love this one.
Jordan Clarkson.
I love this one.
It's easy money.
I love this one because he's a king of the mid-range. And guess what?
Stop.
You reach, I teach. You reach, I teach.
Can we put that on a bumper sticker?
100%.
Reach, I teach. I love 100%. That. I love that. And then last, we got Kevin.
Sorry.
I mean, that was rude. And look at the bench reaction. I hear you.
Yo.
I hear you watching that. I mean, look at the bench. The bench goes.
That's why they call him the sniper, because sometimes it's like, bam, got your ankle.
And you don't even see it coming.
Bam,
oh,
got
man.
Your ankle.
That, like, I. She said, bam,
and then
got your ankle. All right, let's go to Top Dunks. We start in Memphis, where Jared Jackson Jr., I mean, he just perked. He destroys the rim. Can you still get up like that, Park? Now we welcome back Ramona Shelburne. Ramona, Melo's made his mark as a scorer, and you've seen him pick up his game elsewhere.
Yeah, look, defensively, do we think we were talking about on the block and banging with people down there when they're not getting stats? Now, last night he had stats, 4 blocks, 2 steals for Melo. He's never done that.
Yeah, and he, I mean, he was looking good. The Staples Center crowd just, I mean, they erupt for him every single time. But the question that certainly existed at the beginning of the season and is still playing itself out, right, is how are the veterans that you mentioned, how are all of them going to fit together? So what role has Anthony Davis played in that defensive cohesion?
Yeah, look, the season has not been good at all. The least effective player in that starting five has been DeAndre Jordan. So I think he moves to the bench, AD at the five. And yesterday they went with Kent Bazemore and Avery Bradley as the two other starters. Those are defensive guys.
Yep.
Those are defensive-minded players. And this is Frank Vogel saying, this is how this team needs to win.
Yep.
We need to make our money on the defensive end of the ball because they lost a lot of their good perimeter defenders, but now they still have Anthony Davis.
Well, and we saw the Lakers have some success with Anthony Davis at the five on that championship run they made in the bubble. I know you were tweeting about this game, but you know who else, Ramona, who was tweeting about this game?
Let me guess.
It was Big Perk. He was watching the Lakers game intensely last night, late night Perk. So I want to ask you, Perk, what does Carmelo's performance say to you?
It says a lot. And you know, every night with the Lakers, he's either going to be the fourth option sometimes.
I have no problem with you, Big Perk. I want no smoke, and we're on the same page. And I want to give this one example. So if I'm going to touch Big Perk, normally I would not be able, if he was a guard, I would not be able to touch him again until he enters the paint. That's how hard playing defense is. Where should I touch him on his face forever? So if I touched him here as a defender, I cannot touch him again until he entered the paint.
Right.
That was near impossible for defenders. So I think I'm really glad for that focus point.
I knew this was going to be have this discussion with because I got two bigs in here. I need a guard. Can someone like send me a guard so I can get their opinion on this? Really, point guard Momo. We got to get her in here. All right, Wednesday on ESPN. So the Knicks have the city of New York absolutely bouncing. We're going to welcome back in Ramona Shelburne. And Ramona, from your perspective, I mean, we see the bing bong, right?
Yep.
We see all of this kind of going on and this excitement, right, around the Knicks. But is this start sustainable?
I actually think it is because they're not just winning because Julius Randle's having an MVP.
I'm sure Knicks fans are sitting here like, all right, we're bracing. We want to be able to do this. Is this going to be the year that they can kind of continue and take the next step? And you mentioned it. The conversation around the Knicks this summer was, did they really get that much better? And it looks like.
Well, the two additions that they brought in, Evan Fournier
and in Madison Square Garden, looking fly. And speaking of fly, coming up on NBA Today.
Come on, that jersey was legit.
Kirk, I got to tell you, I love like everything Toronto. No touches.
Yeah.
I just feel like it looks old Raptors. Thank you so much to Jamal Perk, Ramona, Chinee for joining us. We're back on E2 tomorrow at 3 Eastern. We'll see you then. You gonna get some pre-sleep now?
Yeah, go get a lot of